Hi everyone, it's Abigail from The Creative Bix, and today I'm going to show you how I made this easy paper cut landscape with lots of real texture and some really pretty colors. So let's get started. So to start out, I'm going to open up a screen size canvas, and for me that is 2732 pixels by 2048 pixels. So I'm just going to select that, and then I'm going to change the orientation from landscape to portrait, just so I have a little bit more room to work with vertically. Today I'm going to be using my Bohemian Daydream color palette, and I'm going to be using this terracotta orange color first. And this palette will be in my Etsy shop, which will be linked in the description below. Now we're just going to start drawing some hills, and I'm going to start around the middle of the canvas. And we're just going to start drawing off the canvas and start drawing onto the canvas. And this brush just looks a little bit too big, so I'm going to turn it down to be about 1%. And I'm just using my Sadie brush, which you can get individually or in this multi-line set in my Etsy as well. So now let's start making a hill by drawing a little wavy line across the entire page. They definitely don't have to be perfect. I like to keep my lines a little jagged because I think it lends itself to the paper cut look a little bit better. And then just drag and drop your color to color fill. And now we want to make sure that we add a new layer for every hill we do. And then we're going to pick a new color, maybe this medium orangish yellow color. For this yellow hill, we're going to start on the opposite side of the canvas around the same height that we started our first hill. And then we're just going to color drop. So for the next hill, we're going to add a layer, and then let's pick this cream color. And we can always change where we want the lines of our hills to intersect. So for this hill, it's just going to be pretty far over, and it gives maybe a little bit more interest to your piece. Color fill, and then don't forget to add a new layer for your next hill. And then we're going to pick maybe this sage green right here. And we're going to kind of go more flat with this one, and then we're going to drag it down a little bit. Then just drag and drop to color fill. Okay, add a new layer, and let's go for a few more hills. Let's go with this bluish green over here, and let's go a little bit steeper with this one, so it goes down like this. Drag and drop to color fill, and then let's just do one more hill. So add a new layer, and let's go with this darker greenish blue, and go even darker here. And we're going to make this one pretty steep too, making sure to go all the way across, and then color fill. Okay, now that we've done that, let's add our background color. I'm going to add a layer on top, and we're just going to drag it to be at the very bottom beneath the rest of the hill layers. I'm going to take this very top cream color that's just a little bit brighter than this hill right here, and because it's behind the rest of the hill layers, it won't cover them. It's going to be color filled right in there behind. So now we're going to add a layer above this background, and for the sun, let's go with this peachy tan color today. I'm going to go over here, and I don't want to directly put the sun in the center, so I think I'm going to put it on the side, and because there's a dip created by the hills right here, I'm going to place the sun above that. So draw a round shape with your Apple pencil and hold down to create an ellipse, which you can see by this box popping up over here. To create a perfect circle, you can tap with one finger while still holding down with the Apple pencil. And if you tap edit shape up here, you can always edit how big or small your circle is. If you're moving the circle around by tapping anywhere besides the blue dots, you can maintain that perfect circle shape. If you tap the blue dots and move those around, that actually changes the shape, so you can decide what you like best. And you can always change between those at the top here, between ellipse and circle. I'm going to keep circle for now, and I'm just going to move it over a bit. Then tap anywhere outside of the circle to exit out of that editing. And now we're just going to color fill our sun. Now it's time to add a bit of shading. To do this, first start off by duplicating every single hill layer. So swipe to the left and then tap duplicate. And we're just going to make sure we're going down the layer panel here and duplicating each hill layer. Now using two fingers, swipe to the right on all the bottom duplicate copies of the layer. This turns on alpha lock, and you can tell with that checkered background here. And you can also check by tapping that layer and seeing the check mark by alpha lock. But same thing, go down the list and make sure you alpha lock all the bottom layers of your hills. And now what we're going to do is we're going to select a medium gray color. So just around the circle, you can slide all the way over to gray, and then you can select a lighter or darker gray. But I'm going to go with a slightly darker medium gray. And then we're going to go back to our layer menu, and then we're going to tap each bottom layer that we alpha locked and tap fill layer. And just do that on the bottom alpha locked layers. Now that we've done that, we're just going to turn off alpha lock on all these gray layers, and to do that, you can just swipe right again with two fingers. Now before I change the blend mode, I'm going to show you what these blend modes kind of how they work. So let's go over to the adjustments menu, tap Gaussian blur, and then tap layer. Now we're gonna blur the entire layer, and right now you can't really see it, but I have it blurred to be about 7.5%, and you can see that right up here at the top. And the farther you tap and drag to the right, the more your layer is gonna blur, but I'm just gonna go back and keep it at about 7.5%. Now, when you zoom out, it is not too apparent, and we can't really see that shadow, so that's where blend modes come in. So tapping that N on the layer, we're gonna change it to linear burn, and now you can see that shadow a lot better. It's a little bit more clear and darker, and it just really enhances the shadow against the other hills. You can mess around with the blend modes to see how they interact with your layers and colors that you have down, and gray is a great color to experiment with the blend modes, and see hard mix would look very different on different colors. But I'm going to stick with linear burn. And to make everything go faster, I'm just going to change each gray layer to the linear burn blend mode, and then we're just going to turn off alpha lock on each one. And the reason you want to turn off alpha lock is because if you try to blur with alpha lock still turned on, it won't work, because it keeps color only on the pixels you've already drawn, and blurring goes beyond those pixels. So make sure you turn off alpha lock and you can make those shadows visible. And the reason we turned on alpha lock in the first place is if I filled the layer when alpha lock was turned off, it would have filled the entire canvas, not just where the hill was. So it would look like this. It would have filled the entire screen, the whole canvas. And so we alpha locked it so that when we tapped fill layer, it only filled the parts of the layer where we had put pixels down. So now we're just turning off alpha lock to slightly blur each layer. So with every single gray layer, we're going to select it. Then we're going to go over to the adjustment menu and tap Gaussian blur. Remember, we blurred that first layer to 7.5%, so you can keep that consistent, or you can look at the piece as you go along and blur more or less depending on what looks best. I'm going to speed this up a bit, but I blurred every layer to be about 7.5% as well, and I'm just going to check to make sure I like the way it looks, and I do. So now let's move on to adding some shadows to the sun. And for the sun, it's going to be a bit different. With our hills, they're all lying and stacked on top of the sky or background layer. But for the sun, I want it to look like it's beneath the piece of paper that looks like the sky. So we're going to add a new layer on top of the sun. Then we're going to go back to our sun layer to open up the menu, and we're going to tap select. So now the sun layer is selected, which means that the circle is included in the selection and the rest of the layer is not. And you can see that where the diagonal lines are, they're telling us that that part is not a part of the selection. And we want to change that and actually flip what is selected. So we're going to tap invert down here. And then with that gray color still selected, we're going to tap the new empty layer, and then we're going to tap fill layer. Then this whole layer will have been filled except for where that sun is. Now we don't want this whole layer to be gray, or at least we don't want to see it. So we're going to tap this layer and change it to a clipping mask. So now this gray layer is clipped to all the pixels on the layer below, which is the sun layer. And because there shouldn't be any pixels overlapping at the moment, you should no longer see any gray. So now we're going to change the blend mode to linear burn. And once again, tap that in and find your linear burn mode. And it's not alpha locked, so we can go ahead and blur it. And so now you should see a shadow a bit, but we're gonna do one even better, and we're actually gonna move this layer by tapping the move tool, and we're gonna turn off snapping to make it move a little bit more smoothly. And I might turn down the opacity for that layer ever so slightly, and I'm gonna have it down at 68%. And now it's time to add the final details and some texture. So we're gonna add a new layer above each of the main hill layers. So tap each colorful hill layer, and then tap the plus sign to add a new layer above it. And then we're gonna add one more extra layer between the sun and that background. So tap the background, tap the plus sign, and now you have that layer there as well. Going back up to this top blank layer, we're going to grab the color white by just double tapping, and by double tapping around the circle, you'll get the pure values of each of those colors. So you can just double tap right near the white and you will get that perfect color. Okay, now I'm gonna grab my pastel brush and turn this blank layer into a clipping mask. So now it's clipped to this dark blue hill layer, and we're gonna go down here and we're just gonna start drawing our paper cut look on this blank layer. And we're just gonna make it look like we've kind of torn this paper. And this brush size is pretty big, so let's turn that down to about 8%. And then you just need to draw across the top edge of the hill. And it doesn't need to be a lot, and you can make it uneven. Some places might have more white or less, and just go across the entire hill. And then we're gonna do this along every single hill so that they'll each have a bit of edging. So let's go back to the next blank layer and turn it into a clipping mask. And while we're at it, we can turn all of them into clipping masks, and that way we won't have to worry about remembering to do that later on. So now that we've done that, we can go through and add that white edging to each clipping mask on their respective layers. So once you have all the edging on the hills complete, we're going to go down to that layer above the background layer, and because the sun layer is above it, I don't have to worry about accidentally drawing on top of it. So I'll just draw on this layer between the sun and the background, but it'll still make it look like the sun is beneath that cream background. And I'm just drawing along that edge on the opposite side of where we had that shadow coming down. Now if you want to make that highlight a little bit bolder, you can see what it'll look like if you duplicate this layer, and that just makes it a little bit brighter against the pale background we have. So if you like that, you can pinch those two together and merge them. Okay, the last thing we're gonna do is add some texture to make this really pop and look realistic. So let's go into our layers and add one more new layer at the top, and then we're gonna go over and pick the color black. Now we're gonna use my canvas texture brushes that include 25 super realistic canvas texture brushes. So today, let's see. I think I'm gonna use my pastel paper canvas. Now all you need to do is make one smooth swipe over your entire artwork. Now to be able to see that texture and everything below it, we're going to change the blend mode. And for this one, let's change the blend mode to overlay. And immediately you can see how much it pops and it looks so much more realistic. And because there are so many brushes, you can always experiment with all the different canvas brushes in that set to see which one goes best with your piece of artwork. You can try something maybe like thick burlap. And once again, just swipe across that entire canvas, and because overlay is already set, you don't need to change the blend mode, and that kind of gives it a fabric look. You can try the stucco canvas, which is always really fun as well. But for this piece, I think I want to stick with my pastel paper canvas and just draw on one more time, one big smooth swipe. And that is how you can make a paper cut landscape. All the products I use are in my Etsy shop. The link is in my description. If you recreate this, I'd love to see it. You can tag my Instagram at @thecreativebix. Thanks for watching and happy creating.